भगवान भोलेनाथ जो अजर अमर है, उनके कोई माता पिता नहीं है, उनका कोई जन्म कोई बतलाता नहीं, उनका कोई मृत्यु नहीं है, और वही साकार रूप में और निर्गुण स्वरूप में विराजमान है, हर एक वस्तु में वही है, शिव है, हर जीव में शिव है, मतलब शिव है, हर जीव में शिव है, मतलब।
I came here looking for someone, but found something else. I guess the universe had a plan while I had none. So this is my journey into the Kumbh and meeting a Naga who shared my name and age.
So let's see if we can get some lead out of the manager about the Nagas.
In 2003, I had stayed with a Naga who belonged to the Atalakara, and I was hoping to bump into him this time. I thought I'll try my luck with the hotel manager about the whereabouts of the Atalakara, but it wasn't of much help, as I'd discover later. In the meantime, I went out to explore the Juna Akhara.
Okay, so now we are off to Juna Akhara, all the way up there.
In 2003, it was all about getting high and chilling with the Babas in their shed. This time though, I was sober as hell and decided to actually explore the Mela in Trimbakeshwar at the foothills of the lush Brahmagiri Hills. But first, I decided to walk around town and visit some of the Akharas. The Juna Akhara, for instance, have quite a reputation of not engaging with us common folks. And soon I found out that there are two sides to that coin. There were Nagas who were friendly and those who had the don't piss me off attitude.
So yeah, I guess we are done here at Juna Akhara and let's just say goodbye to this Baba.
I decided to drive around to locate the Atalakara and in the process ran into the party parade by the devotees of the jail godman Asaram Bapu. Later that night, we explored the Shahi Snan Parade. It was chaotic, it was electric, the crowd was maddening, and the cops did their best to control all the madness and mayhem. The ash-smeared naked Naga sprinting down the road was a sight to behold. After all this madness, it was time to hit the sack. I'll continue my search for Atalakara the following day.
So, I think it's down the road, Atalakara. I think that's what we do. Let's see if we find them. In the meantime, we are having a chai here.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Bhaiya, ye Atalakara kidhar hai pata?
Chalo pe jao.
The search for Atalakara was heading nowhere. But there was still one place left, which is where I would have looked for them if it wasn't for all the wrong information. And that was the foothills of the Brahmagiri Hills itself, which was where I stayed 12 years back. I guess everything has a time and place. And you know what? That's where they were shacked up. But not the Baba I was searching for.
I don't think they're going to be up there.
Instead, I ran into my namesake Naga Baba Mohan, otherwise known as Hari Om Baba. Hari Om Baba had sought to find God at a young age.
That's strange. We have same name and same age.
By 2003, he had even completed a pledge of silence that had lasted 12 years. He was chilled out and I pretty much felt at peace being with him. The lights and the ambience were psychedelic, like a hippie haven. By the time I was strolling through the town that night, after my first encounter with Mohan Baba, I had completely gotten over the disappointment of not finding the other Naga Baba. So this was the plan, I thought. and this is how things were supposed to unfold.
So finally, after a 10-hour delay, we are off for our trek with our Baba here and a bunch of other people. And this was something we planned for the morning, but it didn't happen. So I guess the moral of the story is don't plan anything. Off we go. We're taking some shortcut. I don't know. I've been up there twice, but that's the longer route. And this looks interesting and more adventurous.
You're on a hilltop. You're on a hilltop.
आप इसमें आने की क्या मतलब?
उम्र के 5 साल से भगवान भोलेनाथ की मैं भक्ति करता हूँ, जब से मुझे समझता है। मेरा कोई लक्ष्य नहीं था कि मैं साधु बनूं, कोई नागा बनूं, ऐसा कोई नहीं था। मेरा तो लक्ष्य था भगवान भोलेनाथ को प्राप्त करने का लक्ष्य था, और मैं जाप करते गया, भक्ति भी देवदान से करते गया, अलग अलग जगह तपस्या किया, मतलब ये जगह भी तपस्या किया, तपस्या कर करके मैं उसमें समा गया हूँ।
व्रत क्यों रखा, उसका क्यों रखा और उसका क्या फल था?
तो मैं मौन रखने का कारण ये था कि वो मेरा साधना काल था, 12 साल जो साधना किया, मौन किया, मतलब तो मौन में मेरा ये लक्ष्य था, मैं किसी से गलत ना बोलूं, किसी से अच्छा ना बोलूं और मेरा जाप करने में मग्न रहूं। मौनम सर्व साधनम, कलयुग में मौन ही सबसे बड़ा श्रेष्ठ साधन है।
आपको क्या मतलब, लोगों को मैसेज कुछ बोलना है मतलब?
और उनके लिए यही कहूंगी, सब निर्वेशनीय रहे, अपने माता पिता की सेवा करें, बाल गोपाल की सेवा करें, गाय की सेवा करें, धर्म की सेवा करें, धर्म के प्रति जो ज्ञानी रहेगी उसके बारे में खेटे और अपने धर्म को समझे, सनातन हिंदुस्तान को समझे।
जनता के लिए तो पहला आती है कि निर्वेश नहीं रहे, यानी कि मैं छिलम पी रहा हूँ तो वो भी छिलम पी, तो हम योग करने के लिए पीते है तो वो नहीं पिए, वो तो निर्वेश नहीं रहे और सोशल रहे।
Experience, the trek, the surroundings, the spiritual energy of the place and the Naga felt peaceful and surreal, making me question the chaotic lives we lead back in the city, the bigger picture, the questions and the meaning of life. But I know life is unpredictable and there's only one way it can go and there's no stopping it.
My nephew said, "Uncle, you better to stay in China." I said, "No. India is my hometown. I born in there. I will go back there."
वो कुछ कहना चाहती थी मगर हम समझ ना पाए, इशारे उसके समझ ना पाए, जबान से वो कह ना पाई, बस यही कसक है अपने हृदय में।